Attention race fans, sit back and strap yourselves in. It's time for the Winner's Circle Race Report. And I'm your host, Doug Jenkins. Hello, race fans, and welcome to the Winner's Circle. Friday night, the 23rd of April at the Godfrey Motor Speedway. Street stock feature ready to roll opening night at the Speedway and opening night for the Triple Track Race Group. Earlier winners in the street stocks include Jake Season and Ryan Boving in the heats. John Naylor in car number 12 won the Bud Light Dash. He started on the pole, and he takes the early lead. Naylor leads him around. It's Jim Bell in second and Jake Season in third. A very good showing for the street stocks in the first year where Camaros are not legal under the revised rule book. There you see Tim Schmidt in the 41 car getting around Mad Max Kirkendall. Schmidt moving up to sixth place, closing in on David Buck in the 4B. With weather threatening, feature length was shortened to 12 laps for the street stocks, 15 for the modifieds, and 20 for the UMP late models. Well, John Naylor got a little bit sideways coming off turn number four. He got it straightened out, but that let Jim Bell close right in on him. Later on in this half hour, we'll be going to the Highland Speedway, and get your pens and paper ready. We'll be giving you the address to write to the winner's circle and give us your opinions on any number of things. Whatever's on your mind, write to us and let us know. We'll give you that address in just a little bit, so stay tuned for that. And I'd like to thank you for all your letters and cards that came in over the past week. There's a good shot of Jim Bell in number 17, who is featured on the front page of the Winner's Circle Race paper, a paper not associated with this show, but carries the same name nonetheless, that will be distributed at the Triple Track Racing facilities, Godfrey Motor Speedway, Peavely, Missouri's I-55 Speedway, and the St. Charles Speedway. Peavely and St. Charles were scheduled to open this past weekend, but did not do so due to inclement weather. Peavely is still underwater, being so close to the creek that empties into the Merrimack River, and St. Charles is having drainage problems since it's dug into the ground. Water is naturally finding the lowest point, and that point just happens to be the racing surface at the St. Charles Speedway. But tentative plans are for all three tracks to be in action next weekend, the 30th of April. And the two nights after that, Godfrey Motor Speedway, Peavely, and St. Charles, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Once again, John Naylor, still your leader in the 12-lap street stock feature race. Jim Bell closing ground on him rapidly. As they go down the back straightaway, it's getting close to time to end this race. As they come up on some of the slower cars, there's the turquoise and yellow car, number 44 of Ron Seagraves, getting ready to be lapped. Terry Chester in the number 52 out of South Roxana is a rookie this year in a very, very well done up Ford Fairlane, number 52. There you see him flashing into turn number one. And here we go. It's John Naylor holding off Jim Bell just by a little bit as they come down for the checkered flag. Naylor holding him off, and that's a checker. It's Naylor followed by Jim Bell. You didn't see it, but third place was Jake Seats. Fourth was Ryan Boving. And in fifth was David Buck. And now we see the modified feature getting ready to roll off. UMP sanctioned modifieds this year, trying to get everything under the same banner. It's John Seats on the front row, and alongside is Mike Mudd in the 34. Second row, Tom Seats and Jim Lafferty. Third row, Don Patton and Jake Seats. There's a green flag as the field rumbles into turn number one. Running into turn number three, here they come to complete lap number one. It's Mike Mudd, your leader. John Seats and Tom Seats, second and third. Don Patton having a good ride in his first race ever with the UMP modified. And we've got trouble in turn number two. Rick Rhodes has hit the wall and has rolled over out of turn number two, coming to a rest back there. Rick Rhodes in the double zero, having a rough time on opening night. Earlier heat winners in the modified division were John Seats and Mike Mudd, and the Bud Light Dash was won by John Seats. So with that yellow coming out on lap number two of the 15-lap race, that bunches up the field once again. Mike Mudd bringing them around, and the green flag is out. There you see the rest of the field flash by. Coming down the back straightaway, it's Mudd, John Seats, Tom Seats, and Don Patton. Looks like it may be three wide for the lead as they come out of turn number two. Mudd holding off the charging Seats brothers. Don Patton hanging back there and forth in case anything should happen between the top three. Mudd holds his line in the center of the track. Tom gets a little advantage. Here comes Mike Mudd back on the outside, and John Seats trying to find some running room up on the high side. Coming up on the slower car of Shane Seiler, son of the famous Barry Seiler. And now we do have three wide for the lead out of turn number two. It's John Seats taking the lead. Coming down off of turn number four, a little bit of contact. John Seats, however, manages to pull it to the low side and hold the lead at the start-finish line. Mike Mudd drops back to second. It's now Tom Seats in third. But Tom Seats up on the high side is starting to work his way up, and there's John Seats pulling down low. Something wrong on that car, and he'll pull it to the infield. Tom Seats moves into first place. Mudd is back to second. Tom Seats is still lapping traffic as they come out of turns three and four. Coming up on the black car of Scott Conway, number six. Team car to Terry James, who is number nine. In fact, the two cars are identical except for the numbers. Through turns three and four once again. Scott Conway, look out. He's loose in front of your leader, Tom Seats. Tom Seats collects him. Conway continues, but Seats is spun in turn number four, and that's going to be the end of the night for Tom Seats with a terrible break. So now with just a few laps remaining, it's Mike Mudd, your leader. In second is Don Patton. Third is Jim Lafferty. And there you see the rest of the field underneath the starter's stand. Next time by, they're looking for the start. Mike Mudd has been winning fairly regularly up at Macon Speedway on Saturday nights. Macon, Illinois is one of the NASCAR Winston Racing Series tracks this year. And there's the green flag to start up the feature event once again. Down into turn number three, it's now Don Patton making a charge for the top spot. Mudd's holding him off, however. Mudd has been around this track many times and knows exactly where to find the traction. Not that Donnie Patton hasn't, but Mike Mudd is familiar with the IMCA-type cars, or UMP cars now, I should say. UMP-sanctioned modifieds, the triple track race group. White flag comes out for Mike Mudd. He has one lap to go to pick up the feature win. He's down the back straightaway. There's a good close-up of him coming through turns three and four. And coming around to take the checkered flag. There he is, Mike Mudd, your feature winner. Finishing in second place is Don Patton. Third is Jim Lafferty. Fourth is George Carroll. Here comes the race for fifth place. And at the line is going to be the man on the outside, number 11, Rob Myers. And that'll be the way they finish in the UMP Modified feature event. And here is the UMP late model feature ready to roll. 15 cars coming down on the front row. Jay Sparks. And look out, him and Corey Turner getting a little bit crossed up coming out of the turn number four. Green flag flies anyhow. And Corey Turner has dropped back to third. That puts Tony Izzo Jr. into second place. Izzo was a late arrival. Heat winners tonight were Jeff Simmons and Dick Taylor. The Bud Light Dash was taken by Dick Taylor. There you see some of the other cars heading on through the pack. A little contact there between Simmons and Ed Dixon back there in the number 50 car. Jay Sparks leading lap number two as they come around. Tony Izzo Jr. on the inside. Seeing if there's anything there on the low side as far as traction goes. Jay Sparks hold the lead at the line. Complete lap number three. And here comes Izzo down on the inside. He makes the pass going into turn number three. And coming out of the turn, it's Izzo with the lead. Jay Sparks drops back to second place. And in third place, Corey Turner Oh, look out. Dick Taylor sideways and just about brought out the caution flag. There you see Mark Voigt and Jeff Simmons getting around. And now Dick Taylor will try to work his way back up into contention. And look out. Simmons and Taylor both get to the inside of Voigt and make the pass. Gary Graham and John Beck there near the rear of the field getting ready to be lapped by Tony Izzo Jr. He hasn't been able to pull away from Jay Sparks a whole lot. But he is holding a distinct advantage at the moment. Get your pens and papers out. At the end of this feature race, we'll be giving you the address to write to the winner's circle here. With your questions and comments, let us know what's on your mind. Izzo gets around. John Beck, part of the three-car Dick Taylor team, Dick Taylor Racing, has the cars owned and operated by Dick Taylor. One is driven by his son, Matt Taylor, and one is driven by John Beck tonight. Matt Taylor's other brother, Dick Taylor's other son, is also going to be driving the car on occasion. A little bit of trouble getting by Gary Graham there by your leader, Tony Izzo Jr., but no damage done. And now we see some action there in the rear of the pack. As Graham pulls it to the infield, Ed Dixon got by. Here comes Dick Taylor once again on the inside as we pick up our leader, Tony Izzo Jr. Just a handful of laps remaining now. Izzo still with the lead. Here comes Dick Taylor up on the high side. He's in third, challenging for second place. Taylor up out there. Look out. Sparks pinches him off, and Taylor has to get off the gas to avoid hitting the wall and going up onto the hill just like Rick Rose did earlier. He lost a spot to Corey Turner. As Izzo flashes underneath the flag stand once again. Into turns three and four. Here comes the white flag one more time around for Tony Izzo Jr. Izzo was a semi-regular, or in fact, he was a very regular competitor at the St. Charles Speedway last year. And coming down to accept the checkered flag for the first win of the season, Tony Izzo Jr. In second place, Jay Sparks. Corey Turner finishes in third. Dick Taylor is fourth, and Ed Ballman fifth. Okay, here's that address for you. Winner's Circle, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. And now we're at Highland Speedway the following night, the 24th of April, and here is your modified feature getting ready to roll out, although they are looking more and more like late models all the time. Lumpy Lowry, Randy Gordy on the front row. In the second row, it's Mark Faust and Ron Sensel. Third row, Dennis Sellers and Tom Cease. Those two have been beating on each other all night long. Very good race, and we're just going to let you sit back and enjoy and not be hassled by the commentary. So keep your eyes on the pack. Lumpy Lowry moving into second place. And a very enjoyable evening of racing at the Highland Motor Speedway. Once again, that address was 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. And we'll run down that address one more time before we sign off the air today. Down there in the turn, it all got started when Tom Seats in the number 9 and Dennis Sellers in car number 2 got together. Dennis Sellers has knocked down the fence in turn number 1, the gate, rather, and that's going to require some major work. Also involved are Scott Ford in the 16 car, Jason Kanoyer in the 5 car, among others. There you see Sellers' car being towed off. He was uninjured, but as you can see, the car sustained major damage. Tom Seats was able to continue. And there you see the reline for the restart of the feature race. There's a good three-way battle for the lead. Mark Faust in the 51 has just taken the lead from Randy Cordy. Here comes Lumpy Lowry up there in third place, also dicing for the lead. Randy Cordy back on the high side is trying to regain the advantage. Lumpy Lowry, by the way, set a new track record earlier in the evening, so he just continues to lower the markets into the 13-second bracket now. And Randy Cordy has regained the lead. Randy Cordy only needs to hold on for another half lap to pick up the win. Here he comes around in the double zero car, looking promising for the checkered flag, and there it is. Randy Cordy picks up the win in the modified feature. Second place is Lumpy Lowry, just by a nose. Mark Faust finishes third. Ron Sensel is in fourth. Tom Carson is fourth, and Ron Sensel fifth. Second check it is, Sensel in fourth and Carson in fifth. There is your winner, Randy Cordy, in the double zero. Sportsman feature coming up next, and Marty Smith will be trying to make it 4 wins in a row. And if he does, he'll be the only feature winner so far this year at the Highland Speedway. And I got to tell you, folks, it's a very exciting finish. Stick around for that one. It is guaranteed to get the senses stirred up. There you see the field rolling off, getting ready for the start. Marty Smith flashing by in the orange 55 car. And back at the front of the pack, it's Greg McCray in the 99. The fast qualifier outside is Oscar Fry in the 80. Randy Perkins in the second row along with Rod Timmons in the 5 car. And that start won't hold as Fry didn't come up to speed at the same time McCray did. So they'll re-rack him and try again. Once again, we're just going to let you sit back and enjoy the action from the Highland Speedway. saw Randy Perkins' car being towed off the track. Here it is, the last lap. Marty Smith on the outside, Greg McRae on the inside. Down into turn number one, out of number two, and it's McRae getting into the back of Marty Smith. Smith keeps it right into turn number three. Coming around the turn, McRae gets him in the quarter panel again, trying desperately to take the win, but to no avail. It's Marty Smith taking the win. There you see the crowd, and out of the corner of the picture, you see McRae spinning Marty Smith. That's a disqualification. McRae does not pick up second place. He gets put to the tail. It's Marty Smith, Oscar Frye, Roger Phoney, Kent Zobrist, and Mark Luke, your top five in the Sportsman main event. And there you see Marty Smith carrying the checkered flag around to pick up his fourth win in a row at the Highland Speedway, the only Sportsman feature winner so far this year. And as we close out today's show, we'll tell you that the Street Stock feature event was won by Brian Belong in car number 70. Mark Oller finished in second. Alvin Knoll was third in car number 48. Rick Johnson in the 92 was fourth. And John Pate was fifth in car number 5. Oller number 67 on the pole. So until next week, this has been Doug Jenkins. Don't forget all the tracks up and running this weekend. Belle Claire and Godfrey on Friday night. Saturday nights are full with Peavely's I-55 Speedway, Highland Speedway, and Tri-City Speedway opening up on Saturday night. And then next Sunday is St. Charles Speedway. Until then, this has been Doug Jenkins on the Winner's Circle. Goodbye, everybody. Doug Jenkins, thanks for watching the Winner's Circle, and we'll talk to you next time.
race fans, sit back and strap yourselves in. It's time for the Winner's Circle Race Report. And I'm your host, Doug Jenkins.
Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Winner's Circle Race Report. We're at the Godfrey Motor Speedway on Friday night, the 7th of May. There you see the field of street stockers ready to roll out. Chris Sugarman there in the yellow 617. Brad Smith all the way back there in the green 53. Up in front is Jake Seats in the orange 44S, and alongside him is Doug Cheatham in the Buick Riviera, purple number 76. Next row is Jeff LaBob in the 29 and Jim Bell in the 17 as we get ready to roll out with our first feature of the show, the street stock feature from the Godfrey Motor Speedway. We'll be going to I-55 Speedway later on in the show. There's the green flag, and we've got action. Also, get a piece of paper and a pen ready. We'll be giving you the address here at the Winner's Circle so you can write to us with your questions and comments. And we'd like to thank everybody for the mail that has come in so far. Jake Seats takes the lead. LaBob is running in second place, and Doug Cheatham holds down third in the early laps of the street stock feature at the Godfrey Motor Speedway. It's a three-way fight for the lead. Jake Seats in the 44. There is Jimmy Bell in the 17 car, and Jeff LaBob's down there on the inside. LaBob has just taken the lead away from Jake Seats. And we've got a caution as Tim Schmidt in car number 41 spins in turn number 4. We'll realign and try it again. That'll put Jake Seats back out in front. LaBob did not hold the lead for a complete lap before the yellow came out. So into turn number 3, they'll try it again. Looking good, but no start that time. Flagman Hoot Gibson decided it was a little bit raggedy as they came around. Doug Cheatham and Steve Meyer running 4th and 5th right now, and Brad Smith is working his way through the pack as well in that green 53. And there is a start as the green waves on the field. This time it's Jim Bell moving to the inside, and Bell takes the lead down the back straightaway. Bell in front of Jake Seats and Jeff LaBob as they run through turn number 4. Off the turn, Seats tried to make a challenge, but fell a little bit short, and that lets Bell get away by just a few car lengths. Tracy Meyer on the inside of Doug Cheatham. Both of those drivers are running really good right now. And here we go on the last lap as they come through the back straightaway. Jim Bell is leading by half a track. And there he is, your feature winner, Jim Bell. In second is Jake Seats. Jeff LaBob will finish third. Steve Meyer fourth. And Brad Smith finishes in fifth place in tonight's Street Stock main event. In the UMP late model division, there you see Mark Boyd, who is running in second place. Just a couple laps are remaining in the UMP late model feature. And here we go. White flag is coming out for your leader, Ed Dixon. Dixon has won his heat, and he's also won the dash. And as he comes around the back straightaway, he has just a half lap left before he picks up a feature. And here it is, a checkered flag, your winner, Ed Dixon. Mark Boyd finishes second. Dick Taylor is third. Rick Bear is fourth. And Matt Taylor will finish in fifth place. Ed Dixon picking up yet another win, and he is gunning for the UMP National Championship this year. So far, so good. He's on a tear, and we'll catch up with him in just a few moments at Peavely, Missouri. But right now, it's the UMP Modified feature time. And here are the UMP Modifieds ready to roll on the front row. It's Tom Seats and Rick Bear, second row, Terry James and Scott Weber, third row, George Carroll on the inside, and Mike Hunt on the outside, and we've got a start. Everyone makes it. Whoa, look out. We've got Terry James and Rick Rhodes spun there on the back straightaway. Terry Cox is also involved in the car number 94, and that'll bring out the caution before we even get one lap in. Rhodes and Terry James made a bit of contact as they came through turn number two. Now on the restart, everybody got going again except for Terry James. Green is out, and here we go. Off the turn and down the back straightaway. It's Seats, Rhodes, and Weber, your top three. George Carroll runs in fourth place. The battle is for fifth between Terry Cox and Scott Weber. Tom Seats running on the high side, putting some distance between himself and second place Rick Rhodes. Weber is now feeling a challenge from George Carroll for that third position. And here comes Mike Mudd and Terry Cox making it three wide through the turn. Good racing in the UMP modifies at the Godfrey Motor Speedway. I hope everybody has their pen and paper out, because we'll be giving you the address here at the Winner's Circle right after this event. And now Weber slips high in turn number two. That allows the car of Terry Cox to get around. But the yellow flag flies, so the pass will not count. Jake Seats the third. Little Jakey spinning in turn number four will bring out the caution. Back to the action. It's Tom Seats, Rick Rhodes, and Scott Weber running in the top three. In case you're wondering why Jake Seats' car is a convertible this week, earlier in the evening he flipped the car on the front straightaway at the start of his heat race. He got together with a couple of other cars. He wound up on his roof, but no structural damage was done, so they just ripped off the body that was damaged, and he went racing. The car is handling just about the way it usually does. It's a new car to the dirt. It ran all last year on the pavement with Joe Walsh at the wheels, so they're still working out the bugs, but as far as that flip goes, no damage done, it looks like. We've got a full field of street stock cars as the I-55 Speedway's feature part of the program gets ready to roll. In the street stock action earlier, Daryl Chrisman, Emmett Groves, and Tom Crankle were your heat winners. The dash went to Tom Crankle in the 92, and George Brucker in car number 7B won the semi. There is the field starting lineup with Tom Crankle and Emmett Groves on the front row. It's Jeff LaBob in the second row, and alongside him, as he comes into the picture, is Daryl Chrisman, He was just in the picture for a moment. Now you see him. And in the third row, in car number 77, Rich Boving, and on the outside in 17 is Jim Bell. They're picking up the pace just a little bit through turn number three. They're getting on the gas, and we've got action at the I-55 Speedway. We were planning on bringing you action from the St. Charles Speedway. Unfortunately, the tape did not turn out. So hopefully next week on the Winner's Circle, we'll have action from the St. Charles Speedway, the third track in the Triple Track Race Group. Also trying to get video from Highland and from Tri-City Speedway, so sit tight. If you know anybody that videotapes at a particular track that we do not carry and you'd like to see it on the Winner's Circle, just have them write to us here at that address you saw before, and we'll get with them and try to get the video on the show. LaBob has just moved into second place. Emmett Groves holding on to the lead. And up on the high side, Crankle drifts up and loses his second place. He's back to third. LaBob rim riding, and there is Rich Boving down on the inside. He's also gaining on Tom Crankle, and Crankle's car just doesn't seem to be handling that well anymore. This is only Crankle's second time at the I-55 Speedway. Groves and LaBob and Rich Boving have spent previous years at the Speedway. But Jim Bell, I believe his first time at the I-55 Speedway, really has a handle on things, and he's running up right up there. He's up to about third place. Bell's running in fourth. Rich Boving is third. Jeff LaBob is second, and all the way up there in front is Emmett Groves in the purple number 21. Emmett Groves' car is starting to slow. The 21 is showing a lot of sparks out of the back end. Looks like he may be losing the drive line. And he slows dramatically out of turn number two. Still under power, however, as the drive line finally caught. Looks like the transmission may be where the problem lies as he comes off of turn number four again. Jeff LaBob is closing in on Emmett Groves in car number 21. And Groves has finally lost power, and LaBob moves around to take over the lead. Emmett Groves was the previous week's feature winner at the I-55 Speedway, but now LaBob has about a half straightaway advantage over second place Jim Bell. And look out, Phil Argus getting a little bit sideways as we have caution on the track. That's the 43 of Mike Baker, stalled out of turn number two. Just about done with this event. It's LaBob. Jim Bell is in second place, and Daryl Chrisman is back in third. LaBob gets on the gas. Jim Bell's in second place. Chrisman third. Max Kirkendall's in fourth. And look out on the front straightaway. Asa Hovis in car number seven slams the inside retaining wall. Hovis's dad does the Hovis Racing engines that powered Casey Pearson to the track championship at St. Charles a couple of years back. And now Asa is trying it himself, unfortunately, with not a whole lot of luck tonight. Looking for the restart again. There goes Chrisman on the inside trying to gain an advantage. Here comes Joe Metter up there in car number 12. He's also looking for a little bit of a jump, but flagman Johnny Johnson says, not this time, fellas. They're trying to get the field relined in single file order, but looks like this may be as close as we get. They're coming around turn four. The green flag is waving, and we have action once again. It's LaBob, Bell, and Darryl Chrisman, your top three. Chrisman's working well on the bottom side, however, in car number 11. He looks down there, and he may have the pass made coming off turn four, but he bobbles a little bit. There is the white flag. One more time around for Jeff LaBob. He's trying to hold off Jim Bell, and right now 10 car lengths is the advantage for Jeff LaBob. Coming through turns three and four, LaBob holds the high side. Down the front straightaway, it's LaBob, your winner. Chrisman will finish in second place, getting around Jim Bell, who finishes third. Max Kirkendall will be fourth, and Joe Metter rounds out the top five. There it is, your feature winner, Jeff LaBob. And now it's time for the UMP late model feature. Ed Dixon and Greg Hall on the front row, 50 and 99 respectively. Alan Reddick in row number two on the inside of Rick Bear in the seven car. And the third row will be Bill Faust in the four car. And on the outside, Emmett Groves in the 21 car, trying to have a little bit better luck than what he had in the street stock feature. As the field gets the green flag, jumping out into the lead is Alan Reddick in car number 94. Ed Dixon falls back into second place, but they're side by side for the lead. Track's a bit dusty. Let me tell you what happened. If you've never been to I-55 Speedway before, they're on a back road off of Highway 6167, which is just off of I-55. As you come in to the back road, there is a creek. Right now, it is flooded because it empties into the Mississippi River, and the creek ran over a low spot in the road. So what they did all day was try to pump the water off of the road with the water truck, and in the process, the water truck got gravel into the pumping mechanism. Well, they had to take the entire truck apart to empty out the gravel before they could start watering the track, and by the time that the water truck was fixed, it was about 7 o'clock or so. They made about 4 passes on the track. Luckily, earlier in the week, they got a lot of water on the track. Otherwise, it would have been dustier than it is now. But hopefully, the water will be going down this week on the Mississippi River and all of its tributaries, and won't have to worry about that. In fact, the Peavely management has made a vow to make sure the track is in tip-top shape for this Saturday night's racing show. And I think they'll do it because they are a first-class racing facility. Alan Reddick and Ed Dixon, however, don't seem to mind the track conditions. They're putting on a heck of a battle up in the front. Dixon finally gets down to the low side as he passes Alan Reddick, and it looks like Dixon may start to pull away. The white flag is coming out. There's Alan Reddick, who is running in second place up there in the front. It's Ed Dixon in car number 50. He has a half lap to take around the track, and then he'll be picking up yet another checkered flag. As he comes through turn three and four, here it is, the checkered flag. He will take the win. It's Ed Dixon, followed by Bill Faust. He just got around Alan Reddick, who finished in third. Greg Hall finishes in fourth, and Tom Seitz rounds out the top five. Ed Dixon, your feature winner tonight in the UMP late models. And once again, as we get set to start up the UMP modified feature event, there you see the field rolling away. Here is the address to write to the Winner's Circle. It's Winner's Circle, care of ECTV Channel 6, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. Excellent feature race is coming up. We're just going to sit back and let you enjoy the UMP modified feature race from I-55 Speedway this past Saturday night, the 8th of May. Here comes white flag for John Hobson, trying to hold off Tom Seitz in car number 9. John Seitz is right up there in car number 8. As they come around for the checkered flag, holding them off at the start-finish line, it's going to be John Hobson, your winner. Tom Seitz finishes in second. John Seitz is third. Cletus Blackwell is fourth. And Jake Seitz finishes in fifth. And there is John Hobson carrying the checkered flag around. He'll turn it around and do it backwards style so everyone can take a look. Look out, Matt Simpson just about getting into the side of John Hobson there on the front straightaway. No damage done, however. Hey, thanks for watching the Winner's Circle this week. Next week we hope to have video to go along with this from St. Charles Speedway. Once again, we're trying to get Highland and Tri-City video. World of Outlaws, of course, coming up Wednesday night. That would be last night. So hopefully we'll have some video on that for next week's show. Until then, this has been Doug Jenkins. Thanks for tuning in to the Winner's Circle. Don't forget to write to us with your ideas, questions, and comments at the address we gave you earlier. So until next time, this has been Doug Jenkins showing you some earlier heat race action from the evening in Peavey, Missouri Street Stock Competition. We'll talk to you next week right here on the Winner's Circle.
Attention race fans, sit back and strap yourselves in. It's time for the Winner's Circle Race Report. And I'm your host, Doug Jenkins.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Winner's Circle. This is Friday night, the 21st of May at the Godfrey Motor Speedway UMP Late Model Action. Heat winners were Corey Turner and Ed Dixon. Ed Dixon wins the Bud Light Dash, and here we come for the feature race. Wes Odell on the front row, pole in 44. Outside is Mark Voigt. And at the start, it's Voigt taking the lead. Dick Taylor in second place and Ed Dixon third. Check out the action, and we'll just let it play for you. Ed Dixon, I got to tell you, he was running awful strong Friday night. Rough track and everything. He was bouncing off the wall, straightening the car out. Didn't seem to bother the car a bit as he just motored on to the win in the heat and the dash. Let's see if he can take the feature race. Here's the white flag. One more lap to go for Ed Dixon in the Steak and Shake late model. Car number 50, based out of Granite City, Illinois. Charlie Barr is off in the B Auto Parts machine, taking the checkered flag. And your winner is Ed Dixon. Mark Voigt finishes second. Corey Turner's third. Tom Seitz is fourth. And racer Rick Baer finishes in fifth place. Earlier on in the evening, Keith Steele from Highland Speedway, and we regret not being able to bring you any Highland results this year due to our editing deadlines. He finished third in heat number one after leading quite a bit of it. He finished third to Dick Taylor in second and Corey Turner in first. And there is Ed Dixon, your feature winner tonight. Dixon, by the way, is the UMP and national point leader. He has a pretty good cushion, and we'll try to bring you the national points on next week's show. By the way, if you have any questions, comments, or just want to write to us and say you're out there watching, the address here at the Winner's Circle is Winner's Circle, care of ECTV Channel 6, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. If you didn't get that now, grab a pen and a piece of paper, and we'll flash that address on the screen a little bit later on in the show for you. And now it's time to go racing in our UMP Modified Division in the heat races. Rick Rhodes beat John Seitz and Jake Seitz in heat number one. Tom Seitz beat Larry Hughes and Terry Cox in the heat number two. Bud Light Dash went to Larry Hughes out of Springfield. Tom Seitz was second. John Seitz was third. Front row is Terry Cox and Rick Rhodes. Look out as they come off the turn. There's John Seitz. And whoa! Careful there. The Jasper Engines car just got into the back end of John Seitz. And car 26 done for the night. He's all the way out of Wisconsin and came down here to see what the racing was like. John Seitz is able to continue on, but unfortunately, car number 26, who unfortunately did not sign in and we didn't get a name on, is unable to compete. He has a right rear all messed up due to that contact in turn number two. Okay, we're ready to go back to racing. Still Rick Rhodes and Terry Cox on the front row. John Seitz back there in the black number eight. As they come off of turn number two this time, it's Jake Seitz in fourth place in the blue and orange 44, and Tom Seitz back there in the blue-yellow 9S. He's in fifth. Down on the low side. Look, oh, look out. Rhodes and Cox get together. They spin, and Tom Seitz with nowhere to go piles in. They're going to bring the ambulance out. Tom Seitz is shaking up just a little bit, and the car is a mess. All three of those cars are done for the night. There you see John Seitz climbing out of the car. Rick Rhodes is on the other side, and the crew's calling for an ambulance as they look over the Tom Seitz car. Tom Seitz has been checked out. He's okay, and we're back to the action. It's Terry Cox in the 94 and Jake Seitz in the blue and orange 44. They're the front two. Then it's the yellow 44 of Jim Werner Jr. in the number one blue car of Larry Hughes, who was the Bud Light Dash winner. And back there in fifth place is the 20 of Marvin Fry. Looking good down there through three and four, and hey, come on, the Bob Noggle car. That car is for sale, and he's trying to get the thing sold so he can afford to put a motor in his son's car. It's a good starter car, and they've had some people looking at it. We may just see a couple more late models coming out, including the Clay Noggle car, as soon as Bob gets his modified sold. Car number 94 of Terry Cox now goes around the 11 of Wes Weinman. He's converted his street stock from last year, and also the 19 car of Gary Fox. They split the difference, and here comes the front three on through. Interesting to note that Terry Cox in the 94 and Jake Seitz in the blue 44 are both former track champions in the old sportsman division. And 1 year, I believe it was 85, those two were fighting for the championship in the points battle, and it came down to the last night of the season. They were tied in points, and whoever finished ahead of the other driver would win. Jake Seitz broke as he brought out a new car, and he thought the new car would give him an advantage, but one of the bugs had not been worked out, and Terry Cox wound up winning the title by just a few points. The yellow is out, by the way, for car number 19 of Gary Fox, and he'll get a push off and be back in the race. Just a couple of laps left. It's still Terry Cox leading Jake Seitz. And Larry Hughes has moved up into third place, down into turn three and four. Cox comes down. Whoa, look out. There's Jake Seitz spinning right into the side of Terry Cox. Racing accident that could have been avoided, but it was just hard racing. And those two will restart on the back of the pack. Your new leader is going to be Larry Hughes in car number one. Larry Hughes out of Springfield, Illinois, running strong, accepts the white flag. Back there in second place is the battle between Marvin Fry and Mike Mudd. Out of turn number two, it's Hughes down the back straightaway, car number one, the RC Motorsports car, bringing it around three and four. Here comes the checkered flag, and your winner is Larry Hughes. Marvin Fry will finish in second place. Mike Mudd will be third. Tom Skeeters, also from Springfield, former late model driver, finishes fourth. And Dale Russell will take home fifth place in the modified main event. Street stock action coming up. Stick around. And there is Hughes in the winner's circle with flagman Hoot Gibson and our trophy queen, Tina. Here's some action for you in the street stock main event. Jeff LaBob is leading. He was the winner of heat number one over Bert Jacoby and Ron Hunt. Max Kirkendall won heat number two over Tim Schmidt and Jake Seitz. The Bud Light Dash went to Jeff LaBob. Max Kirkendall was second and Ron Hunt third. And here we are in the feature event, winding down to the closing laps. Jeff LaBob has been on a tear lately. There's Jake Seitz in second place. Mad Max Kirkendall driving the PT's number nine. Just a couple of laps left. Jeff LaBob, who has won a pretty good percentage of his races so far in 1993, is carrying about a half straightaway advantage to the white flag. Here we go with one lap left. But look out, I believe we have a spinner there on the front straightaway. That's Denny Bell in car number 53, bringing things to a halt as he got up in the wall and couldn't get the thing to the pit area after some front end damage. That's the old John Stanton automobile, and just out of a matter of more trivia, that used to be my car as well. I bought the car and never got it running, so best of luck to the Bell crew, and hopefully they can keep the thing running, and etc. and so forth. Back to the action as his crew chief Wade Glover comes out and takes a look at the car. We're just about ready to end this street stock feature. White flag was coming out for Jeff LaBob. The week previous at the Godfrey Motor Speedway, Ron Hunt took the win after Jeff LaBob had fuel pickup problems with just a couple of laps to go. Otherwise, LaBob may very well have been the defending week's champion at the Godfrey Motor Speedway as well. Now they're finally getting the Bell car off of the track. And we're just about set to go back to racing. John Naylor there in car number 12, Monte Carlo. Has a big fan club, and he's been running fairly well this year. He just hasn't been able to catch a break. Down the back straightaway we go, looking for the green flag, hopefully, as they come by this time. The yellow light is out, the field bunches up, and we're going racing with two laps remaining. LaBob just jumps out to a huge lead, one of those Dale Earnhardt restarts where he just leaves the pack behind. Ryan Boving there in car number two, bouncing through the holes. He's back in fourth place, battling with Bert Jacoby in the pink 24. White flag is flying for Jeff LaBob. Half a lap to go for Jeff as he takes car number 29 down the back straightaway. And through three and four, here we come for the checkered flag. Looking good, and LaBob will be your feature winner. Jake Seitz finishes second. It's Max Kirkendall in third. Bert Jacoby is fourth. And flying, Ryan Boving is fifth, as you see Steve Myers and Scott Adney get tangled up in turn number four after the race is over. Or as they were coming down for the checkered flag, they got tangled up. And there he is, Jeff LaBob, taking his Chevelle around the track with the checkered flag. Hey, we're going to Peavey. Get those pens and papers out. Here comes the address for the winner's circle. As we take a look at the action at the I-55 Speedway last Saturday night in heat number one for the late models, the address is winner's circle, care of ECTV, Channel 6, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. We'll give you that address one more time before we sign off tonight. But here we go with the first UMP late model heat. Since we won't be showing you the full action, we'll tell you that the feature winner tonight was Bo Smith in the B7. Greg Hall finishes second in car number 99. Mark Voigt in car number 30 is third. Emma Groves is fourth in car number 21. Rick Bear in the 7 is fifth. We'll flash that address on the screen a couple more times before we head out of here. We're just going to put the microphone down, let you enjoy the racing action as if you were actually there. One of the things we like to do here at the Winner's Circle. But if you don't like it, write us and tell us about it. Questions or comments, care of the Winner's Circle, or at the Winner's Circle, care of ECTV Channel 6, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. Here in the UMP Modified Division, we're watching the first heat, and tonight's feature winner in the UMP Modifieds is car number 9S Tom Seitz. John Hobson finishes in second place. Jake Seitz will be third. Don Heiletag will be fourth, and Joe Cooksey will round out the top five in the UMP Modified Division. Tom Seitz is just on fire. And there you saw the street stock results from last Friday night at the Godfrey Motor Speedway. But as we said earlier, Tom Seitz is just on fire in the modified division. Here comes action from our second street stock heat of the night. Jake Seitz won the first heat. Paul Van Deer is going to win this one over Bob Schmidt and Jim Brown. Jeff LaBob will take heat number three. Eddie Lowry Jr. will win the B main, and in the A feature, it'll be Jeff LaBob taking the win over Jake Seitz, Chris Sauté, Jim Brown, and Bob Schmidt. Jeff LaBob undefeated this past weekend, as he also won all of his races at the St. Charles Speedway, the heat and the feature. 7 for 7, he's going for 8 in a row Friday night at the Godfrey Motor Speedway. And he's definitely one of the drivers that's going to be one to watch next year, as he does have plans to get into a modified. And we wish him well in that endeavor. We also wish him good luck in continuing his winning ways in 1993.
Thank you.
Attention race fans, sit back and strap yourselves in. It's time for the Winner's Circle Race Report. And I'm your host, Doug Jenkins.
Race fans, and welcome to the Winner's Circle Race Report. Unfortunately, the tape from Peavely, Illinois did not turn out this past Saturday night, although we can tell you it was a terrific racing program, and Jim Durbin was one of your winners, along with John Seitz, and Joe Geisler was a street stock winner. What we're doing right now is flashing back to the August 1st, 1990 show at the Tri-City Speedway, the first time the NASCAR Busch All-Star Tour appeared on the half-mile track. Right now they're showing the NASCAR Modifieds. In the lead is Sonny Smizer in the 11 car. Joe Houck is in second place in the 92 car. There you see Sonny and Joe right there. And Sid Lill in number 12. As we get ready to go back to action, we'll be showing the entire 50-lap feature, which featured Ken Schrader driving the Budweiser number 52. Ed Kosciuszko in the Banquet number 52, and also Kevin Gundaker, who is driving his orange number 11, a trademark around the St. Louis area. We'll just let you sit back and enjoy the action from Tri-City Speedway on August the 1st, 1990. One of the reasons we are showing this event is because Tri-City Speedway will be hosting the NASCAR Busch All-Star Tour coming up on Wednesday night, the 23rd of June, which is not too much farther away, and hope everybody will go out there and support the late models and support the late models wherever they race. Godfrey Motor Speedway on Friday nights, Peavely, Missouri's I-55 Speedway on Saturday nights, and St. Charles Speedway on Sunday nights. The Triple Track Race Group in action in the St. Louis area. And once again, if anybody is videotaping at any of the local tracks that we do not cover on the Winner's Circle, that includes the drag strip or the sports car set, we'd be more than happy to put something on if you'll get in contact with us here at the Winner's Circle. This is care of ECTV Channel 6, 400 North Main, Edwardsville, Illinois, 62025. So here we go with the remainder of the modified main event from 1990's Tri-City Speedway.
come over and we'll talk to you for a moment. Are you people whistling for Sonny or the Trophy Girl? Trophy Girl, sure, I knew that. The applause was for Sonny, the whistles for the nice young lady presenting the trophy.
Gasoline fix, you know. I got a good whiff of there a second ago.
We won't keep you long because you're a busy guy tonight. You're running in both the late models and modifieds. Are you going to have sore arms tomorrow, or have you been doing this long enough that that's no hassle?
No, it's a hassle because the pits are in a hell of a place here. Getting lined up one race to the next, that's the only hassle. You know, driving, just driving.
Yeah, but it's worthwhile when you bring the car home in first place, isn't it?
Oh, it's great. Hey, we'll be sure to thank Terry Whitty and NASCAR. Thanks for everybody coming. Putting on a hell of a show for you.
How about this track? Is this to your liking?
Oh, yeah. I've raced here in the past. Last time I was here, I ran a sprint car and finished about 3 inches ahead of Kenny Schrader.
When this race was about half through, we had a yellow flag come out, and that tightened up the field. You'd built up a long lap before that point, and then that put Hanford in car number 61 within striking distance with just a couple of lap cars between you guys on the restart. Were you aware that he was back there, and were you concerned?
Yeah, I saw it on the lineup board with 92 and another lap car between us, and then I saw Bruce running second. You got to be worried he's behind you because he's passed me a bunch of times.
Well, congratulations. Any predictions on the next race?
Hey, Schrader's my man.
Okay, good luck to you. Thanks a lot. Nick Taylor, Steve Frazee in 45, 96 Johnny Sadoff. Look at turn number 4 behind that beautiful Chevrolet Pace car in 4-press formation. The Bush All-Star Tour late models. Let's get